Now that we know how to find the reflection coefficient for regions with 2 and 3 layers, let's figure out how to get the electric and magnetic fields. We're going to start with the electric fields. Here's the boundary between my two materials, region 1 and region 2. Let's say that I have a plane wave that's propagating in this direction. That's the direction of propagation, or the k vector. For this problem, let's say it's propagating in the z direction. Now I need to know how my electric field is polarized. Let's say that I made this electric field using an antenna that was held in this direction. The electric field would be propagating out away from this antenna in the z direction, as you can see, and the electric field would be oriented or polarized in this direction. So I would end up with an electric field, an incident electric field, that's polarized in this vertical direction. Let's say, for this problem, that that's the x direction. When the wave hits the boundary, it's going to reflect, and the reflected field is going to be going in the minus z direction. The orientation of the electric field stays the same, though, or its polarization stays the same, so there's my reflected field with a negative z direction of propagation. Now let's write our equation for the electric field. The electric field, total electric field, is going to be a sum of these two fields. The incident field is going to have an incident field magnitude that we're going to call E0+. It's going to be traveling in the negative z direction, and we're going to use gamma z to represent that. Because it's going in the positive z direction, we put a negative here in front of the gamma. Gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, so we end up with E0+ e to the minus alpha z, e to the minus j beta z. This is our incident field. It is propagating in the plus z direction. Now we also need to write the vector part of this, the polarization. The polarization here is x directed because it's in the vertical direction. That's just telling us which way the electric field is oriented. Now let's write the part for the reflected field. That's going to have a magnitude of E0 reflected, let's call that E0 minus. That's the magnitude of the negative traveling electric field. It's going in the negative z direction, so we put positive gamma z here. That's going to give us e to the plus alpha z, e to the plus j beta z, and its polarization is also x polarized. Now the magnitude of this reflected field is the reflection coefficient times E0+. Which reflection coefficient is this? It's the reflection coefficient right here, which was at O1, so it's gamma 1 at O1 times E0+, and both of these are polarized in the plus x direction. So there's our equation for the electric field, total electric field in region 1. Now let's also think, so there's a total electric field in region 1. Let's also think about the electric field that's over here in region 2. If we were looking at our three-layer region, that would be at minus D2. So E2 is going to have a positive and a negative traveling wave. Let's just consider the transmitted wave. That's the part that's going in the plus z direction. So let's write the part just for the transmitted. That is going to be E0+ times a transmission coefficient at minus D2. The transmission coefficient at minus D2 is 1 plus the reflection coefficient at O1. And then we need to figure out which way this wave is going. It's going in the positive z direction, so we write that as e to the minus gamma z. And then which way is it polarized? The electric field is going to be polarized in this direction, the positive x direction. Now a lot of people wonder why it's e to the 1 plus gamma. It's not a mistake. It's not supposed to be e to the minus gamma. It's 1 plus because our incident field and our reflected field add up here at the boundary, and the boundary condition is going to say that they're going to be equal to the total transmitted field. So this is actually correct. In just a moment, we'll be talking about the magnetic fields in this picture.